Hey everyone, how's it going? Welcome back to another Let's Play with author J.P. Edgar, where this guy plays some games he's never really played before. And today we are continuing our rain-soaked journey with Raincoat on the Nintendo Switch. So, without wasting any more time, let's get going. How you doing today, chat? How are you doing? Man, I've had a pinch in my shoulder. Like a nerve pinch in my shoulder, and it's crawled up my spine and my neck. Yesterday, I was really stiff. I could barely move some. I felt like I was Batman in the costume. Whenever I turned, I was just like, I know you can't see it, but my feet were like planted facing that way. So I'm just like, because I couldn't turn my neck. It was really painful. It sucked. It just really sucked. So that's kind of how things went. As per the agreement yesterday, when it comes to the murder mystery labyrinths, we're going to extend our stream times. So that's something we're going to have to get ready for. But that's for later. But what that also means is we're going to keep streaming today until we finish this labyrinth. One way or another, this labyrinth is going to be done today. It could be finished within like 5-10 minutes. It could be finished within like next 2 hours. I don't know. We'll see. I've been mistaken on the length of, well, everything about this before. So that's kind of how it is. So, yeah. But how are you doing today? How are you all doing? I won't be streaming this weekend. However, I got a highlight for you. I took some time over the past couple of days to get all of my videos uploaded. Asterisk. All the videos are uploaded, but they're going to be on a schedule. So one episode is going to be released a day this weekend until I'm caught up. So hopefully by Tuesday, the next time we stream, everything will be uploaded. You all will be caught up. My archives will be caught up, and we'll be good to go. In addition, I'll be finished with the class because I have a major test. I have a final tomorrow. So that's going to be, I'm kind of nervous about it. I'm not as prepared as I want to be, but I'm also scoring high on all of the preliminaries and stuff like that. But it's just one of those things. Like I said, I'm not as prepared as I usually am, but we'll see how things turn out, right? Anyway, let's get to this.
Damn it.
Oh, we already got this because we were walking around the rooftop trying to figure out what our next move was. All right, so we talked to these two. Ooh, spooky ghost. Sorry, I'm late. Hey, no problem. Don't worry about it. So we already kind of looked off in the distance. So it's not going to read anything to us. So it's going to be something else. So let's walk the perimeter, see if we can find something to interact with. I just finished a personal stint with Souls of the Sons of the Forest. I keep saying Souls, Sons of the Forest. Okay, hold on a minute.
Hey, check it out.
There we go. Such a funky bassline.
Seem connected to anything else.
Which means that could be the Who location.
So the true culprit is over there then? But how do we reach it? It's not connected to another route.
What, are you freezing up? Scared of heights or something?
Oh, it's not that. About those three routes.
I kind of got caught up in the baseline to pay attention to the story. It's not a real place. How are you able to draw?
Do you carry that around with you all the time?
Did it come from the Shinigami's mouth too?
Who knows when I'll be asked for my autograph? Done. Isn't it perfect? I'm just as good at drawing maps as I am at remembering a pretty face.
Apparently.
This is the How route when seen from above, right? What about it? Well, this is a dungeon, right? So maybe there's some secret paths in here. Secret paths? See? If you look at it this way, doesn't it all seem like the same road? You're right. The three How routes are connected into a single route all the way to the Who room. Wait, all three are connected? That's it. I think I've got it. That's the hidden truth behind the How route. There's only one explanation for how the victim could have been poisoned. What? Seriously?
Not bad. You finally made yourself useful.
Yay! Shinigami
complimented. Shinigami complimented me. I keep wanting to say the, as in a noun, not necessarily a name. Oh my gosh.
If you think you've got this, I'll back you up. Lay it all out.
My tooth hurts, but I'm here, so love me. Oh, you know I do. You know I do. All right, what's going on here? What type of barrel madness is going on? Shinigami puzzle! What's the only possible way the crime was possible was having an... Okay, interesting. I pushed the button. Why don't you button pushy? There we go. Una mas. Ataichi. Here we go. There we go. You getting that tooth fixed, Kai? Hello, Shinigami. It's the summer, you take your girlfriend to the beach, she just sits there, then all of a sudden hearts and lasers shoot out of her face. What do? Order ice cream,
duh. Right. Accomplices. The truth of this case is that Yoshiko, Warona, and Kurane were all accomplices and committed this crime together. Accomplices? But don't they hate
I think that's
guts?
The guys.
You drew this map, Desuhiko.
Got it fixed. That's well, I'm glad to hear it. That's why it hurts, though. Yeah, my hurt for the there, so.
Each of them were suspects, but they were all ruled out because of certain details of the case. That makes sense. If we look at them separately, we get dead ends. But by connecting all three routes like this, and looking at it as a single criminal act, clearly becomes one path forward. They were accomplices.
Mm-hmm. So yeah, I was right.
This murder would have been impossible to commit alone. We figured that out during the How route. But if the three of them worked together, they could make it possible.
A pickaxe. A randomly floating pickaxe.
What's this?
Thanks to my help, don't you think?
And don't you forget it.
I think it deserves a sound effect, doesn't it? Like just a subtle sound effect.
Anyway, let's check it out. We have to make sure we're on the right track.
There's something randomly floating down is just... And nothing? You're just like, what the heck is that? Next up is a zoom! So are we going to have a nine-person murder plot by the end? Because so far we have a one, two, and three. Yeah. Actually, we have four. So I think it's going to double every time.
The three of them divided up the tasks that needed to be done to pull off the murder.
So if it doubles every time from 1 to 2 to 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128. We're going to have 128 culprits. No, 256 culprits by the time we get to chapter 9. 256. We have an entire battalion of culprits.
Don't you think so, Yuma? Yeah, I think it's the only way.
It's the whole city. Yeah. Everyone is guilty.
Oh, you sure sound confident.
Getting your arteries sliced off like that. How did the three work together to pull off an impossible crime?
We have to expose the secret behind their complicity.
Some murder on the Orient, BS.
They cooperated together in the timeline of the crime.
Got it. The timeline, huh? Then the first thing to discuss is...
How was the poison mixed into the glass? How was the poison brought into the theater hall? And how was the poison glass chosen? I guess I have to go through all three of them. So let's do that. So chat, what's going to happen if 1 hour goes through and 1 hour in the chat goes and I get into a murder mystery labyrinth and it takes 3 hours? Does that mean I'm gonna have a 4 hour stream? Is that what I hear? Is that what you want me to do? Because currently I think it's been very coincidental that we've had the mystery labyrinth like pop up at the end of an episode. So the next episode we were able to start the mystery labyrinth. But what if it was in the middle of it? Because obviously the mystery labyrinths are taking 2 hours. Let's go. Oh, criminy chat, criminy. But what about dinner? This guy has to food all day stream. Oh no. All right. I'll consider it. Crap. Let's go, Game Boy, 11th time. Oh my gosh. Okay. And I am not a Nintendo handheld console. Thank you.
Yeah. So, hey, something feels wrong here. The door!
Watch out! It's falling over!
Wait, wasn't it supposed to go through all three of them? Like, wait, so I... Wait. Okay. I thought I had to go through all three doors. Like, I was going to go through one, get the questions answered, go through the second one, just like I did last time. So apparently, this is a question that I need to answer. Well, okay, what's the question? Okay.
Come on, hurry up.
Have you decided on a door to go through yet? Just pick one already. Well, it's now a 50-50 shot because, you know.
We just have to follow the sequence of events, right? So we gotta figure out where the poison came from.
Where the poison came from? How was the poison brought to the theater hall? I mean, how do the three work together? I mean, it's all relevant. It is all relevant at this point because how was the poison mixed into the glass? That was like the unanswered question that we had. Well, for the most part, unanswered. How was the poison brought into the theater hall? Which was from What's-Her-Face rushing in Naruto-style running, handing it off to... 1, 2, 3. Someone from the prop. I don't know. Something from the props. But either way. So. And then we had the lights. So.
You want to go with.
You know what? At this time, let's just pick.
Are you sure you want to pick that door?
Yeah. Hey.
Okay. Like I said, it is all relevant. I don't quite understand what this game wants, but apparently it's the middle door. I guess it's the middle one. I don't know.
Let's start with the poison being brought to the theater hall. Their conspiring began with how was the poison brought to the theater hall.
Okay, I guess that's what they were after. Okay, I understand the question now.
Hey, wait!
I understand what they were asking now. I was really baffled at what they wanted.
The only person who could have brought the poison to the theater hall was Yoshiko, right?
Let's just take a moment to admire the ridiculousness that is on the screen. She is flying so fast that Black Star is going horizontal. And Yuma is keeping up. So that is a ridiculous amount of speed, but the background is not moving very fast. So I think whatever Black Star is holding onto, he is actually holding himself horizontal. It actually isn't the wind. He actually has some buff core strength.
Yeah, the poison neutralizes after 30 minutes, so it had to be brought into the theater during the show. As the production assistant, only Yoshiko could have done it. Looking back, the reason they chose poison as the murder weapon was to establish an alibi.
The poison was only active for 30 minutes, which gave the other girls an alibi.
Yoshiko went to the lab for the poison as soon as the performance began. She had the extra glass hidden in her bag. After she brushed poison onto it, she put it back in her bag and returned to her seat in the front row as if nothing happened.
Mm-hmm.
The problem is, what happened next?
We're here! You're off, Master!
Yeah.
What did Yoshiko do with the poison glass after bringing it? Handed it to Warna? Karana, what did Yoshiko do with the poison glass after bringing it? It wasn't Waruna. It had to be Karana. I'm getting the names wrong again, aren't I?
Wasn't the right one.
You're so pissed.
Let's think again about it. Okay, I'll try.
I'm getting the names mixed up. Poison glass. I'm trying to remember when the screen, like when the lights went out. Let's just go with Wanrona. And reach the truth.
Whoa. Hey, you said Yoshiko handed the poison glass over to Waruna, but Waruna was performing on stage, right? How could she receive the glass while on stage? The only time I can think of is when they turned off the lights. Yoshiko sat on the right edge of the front row close to the wings, where the actors enter and exit from scenes. She probably stood up when the lights went out and left the poisoned glass near the right wing. Even if she couldn't get on stage, she could at least do that within 5 seconds. Then, Warna picked up the glass and hid it under her costume. The costume check happens before the performance. So she got around that by receiving the cup during the performance.
I see. So they passed the baton during the 5 seconds the lights were out.
The two of them must have rehearsed it as much as the rest of the play.
But what happened after that? Suppose Waruna did get the poison glass. How did she swap it with the real glass while the play was still ongoing?
A few moments after the blackout, there's a scene where Warna approaches the shelf. It only lasts 2 or 3 seconds, but Warna's hands in the shelf are completely hidden from the audience. At that moment, Warna could have switched out the original glass with the poisoned one.
Mm-hmm.
So they used the play itself for their seemingly impossible crime. talk about guts. This is something only thespians could pull off.
Shinigami? Isn't there a safer way down?
Master, hurry up and break this one down too!
Alright, what is the question I know the answer to, but I'll get it incorrect anyway, because that is apparently what I do. That is my forte, getting the correct incorrect. How was the poison glass chosen? Karune guided to it. They knew I was going to fail, so they only gave me two choices.
Alright, we got this one too.
They're like, you know, he's going to fail, so let's just give him a 50-50 shot instead of a 33.33 repetitive.
This is the final one. It's the how was the poison glass chosen? From here, it's exactly as we solved it before. Kurune told Karin beforehand to take the glass to spotlight first. And then, after confirming the poisoned glass from the catwalk above, the spotlight was pointed directly at it. That's the method behind the murder weapon.
Method? Sounds more like
madness.
That solves this mystery. We've almost reached the truth. Seriously? That's terrible. Huh? Why? Because I haven't gotten Shinigami to fall for me yet.
That's not gonna happen. Even if you stay here for 100 years. In fact, I basically hear that.
You know, beyond the hate, there could be love.
Black Star has a 50 no's and a yes mentality.
Traveling the globe, you and I can go in opposite directions. But eventually,
we'll meet.
That's a stretch. I feel sick.
This is the last wall.
Who murdered Karin?
Let's solve this thing.
Well, all three of them.
Right. Yes, it fell. And behind that door is the Hoo Room.
Okay, I can move, but I'm not going to move. I'm just going
to
let it go through. Alright, apparently I do have to move. So I was kind of wondering if the moving was moot, was futile, because it didn't matter. But apparently it does. Apparently it does. Karune was the girl in the bow tie. Waruna is the girl on stage. Karin is the dead girl. Okay, it's almost over. I don't remember the names. When did detectives get to choose all the above? Because they were all friends. Yeah, see, they were all friends, and then Karin murdered Aika? Aki? I think it's Aiki. Akai? Something like that. So, the lady who starts with an A, the 6 months ago, to get the lead role. So they had to pretend to hate each other to alleviate suspicion, but they all had the picture cut up, so they actually had like the semblance, you know, the small tie-in.
Why do they look so sad?
Then act like it. Just finish it.
There.
Because they're all like best friends. Sorry, I'm late. Have Blackstar and Yuma kissed yet? Yes. They had a full makeout session. I have to black it out in post. No. They've gotten close. Yuma and Blackstar are bred. The Shinigami is the filling. Trash. No kiss. Trash. Alright, it is time for us to hurdle through things, kick, jump, and tackle with a buttons combination that I don't quite remember. So let's see how things turn out. AX. Kick, tackle, jump. Tackle is Y. I pushed Y. So then B is jump. Okay. Destroy the wall with the solution key. Okay. Here we go. Yeah. So that's okay. 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 I got it. I think I got the button combinations down. I don't have the button combinations down. I thought I had it, but I didn't. I just showed you. I just showed you the picture. All right. Very well. I'm not even looking at the clues. I'm just looking for the picture. I'm just looking for the picture. This game is so damn weird. Yeah.
That's right.
All right. Next is probably going to be jump, which is B. Push the downmost button to jump. Stop telling lies. Tell you, why don't you try that line again? Just reread it. Here we go. The picture again. There we go. I'm not reading the question. I'm not reading the solution keys. I'm just looking for the picture. Kick, jump, tackle. Got it. Got it. I have the button combination down this time, in theory. All you have to do is say yes once, right? it's so cringe. Yeah, this game definitely is unusual. Interesting story, though. Not the greatest script, but an interesting story. I like the mysteries. The mysteries got me thinking. Why did she kick in the air for no reason? Anyway, as I was saying, I both overthink and underthink all the things. There we go.
This is the truth of the case.
And they have these Sailor Moon animations to extend the duration of the game. Since when do these anime-style games have great scripts, though? I can't argue that. I can't refute it. Valid question. But that's the truth of the case. I was going to swap out the Switch base, but...
You three weren't actually on bad terms with each other, were you?
I'll talk later.
In fact, it was all an act to get revenge for Aiko.
Aiko, that's the name.
You all cherished the same picture with her. It was originally a single photo of you all together, with Aiko in the middle. You were all close friends.
And when... you connect the pictures together. Everyone is there, smiling. So, why?
Come on, we've got work to do before you get all sappy. Let's go. One more push and we'll be done with this labyrinth.
What a hero do? A real defender of justice would defeat evil here and now and be done with it. But I'm no hero. All
you keep saying that.
Truth. And the truth is right here. So why go any further?
Yeah, because as soon as he's done, all three of them will die, right?
Really? Make anyone happy?
But it'll save the person that hired you, the flat-chested Uggo.
A detective should do. Your job is to solve mysteries, isn't it? If so, you have to expose the truth. You have to prove it in a way anyone can understand and anyone can see. Detectives aren't defenders of justice, they're defenders of truth.
Defenders of truth.
A detective must never overlook a mystery. Any and all truths must be exposed.
Or Fahlara's version at a cost. Solving a case. Unless unpaid.
Emotions must be discarded to reach a perfect solution through a perfect deduction. It's easier said than done.
So if you learn the mantra, you can be a detective. Is that what I understand?
Do it. I can take your place.
No. I'll do it. I'll take responsibility. I'll see this through.
Is it manga time? Is it manga time? I think it's manga time. It is manga time! Okay, let's see what chat's got. To be fair, when does real life have good scripts, okay? That's what writing is, making real life seem more eloquent. Interesting that it is. A detective's job is to be the victim's advocate. To see with eyes unclouded by hate. Okay. Shame on you, chat. Alright, so what we got? What we got? We got... Karen and Aiko argue. Karen shoves Aiko. That's when Kara steps into the flower bed. What weapon... That's right, I can use the D-pad. The Riku! Karen sneaks up behind Aiko, brick in hand, impulsively beats her to death. That's okay. Replace the brick, begins faking Aiko's death, runs off with shoes. Corpse is located from rooftops. Karen looks down for the rooftops. What was Aiko's cause of death disguised as? What was Aiko's cause of death disguised as? Everything's locked, so it looks like I might actually have to come back to this one. F- theater before the performance began. Yoshiko, Waruna, and Karune get into position. A greeting by Karen. Yoshiko leaves during the performance. I feel like I'm missing something. Yoshiko travels to the halls. I have to go in order? Okay, so I'll go back and I'll... So we have the glasses are swapped, the note in the script, and we have the brick, which is already checked. Locked, 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 locked. Everything else is locked. So this time I'm not going to be able to go in order. That's why, chat. Where was Yoshiko headed? Moron. Yeah, this has to be out of order. This has to be out of order. What did Yoshiko apply to the glass? I don't have that either. Yoshiko applies poison to the glass. Spoiler alert in the previous panels. Preparations completed. Yoshiko returns to the theater. Yoshiko resumes watching performance. 30 minutes in. Yoshiko places the poison glass on stage. Waruna prison wallets it. Goes to the cupboard mid-performance. What did Waruna do? Glasses are swapped. So this gives me suicide by jumping and the spotlight and poison. There we go. We applied the poison, which gave us the chemistry lab, which is going to be right here. Where was Yoshiko heading? To the chemistry lab. Haha, chats! Alright, we now have note in the script, suicide by jumping, and spotlight. So let's see if we're missing one. There we go. Suicide by jumping. Then we're going to go... So, Waruna swapped glasses. Karune watches Waruna's actions from above because it was noted that she did it notably slower. Karen brings the bottle and the glasses. Wine is poured into the glasses. Waruna shuffles the glasses. Karen shuffles the glasses. Glasses shuffles the glasses. Karune watches the catwalk. Karen keeps track of the poison glass. What did Karen use to guide Karen? It's a toss-up between spotlight and notes. I think it's going to be spotlight. Guides Karen using the spotlight. Karune points the spotlight at the glasses. We're still on this case at 5 episodes. This game is so long. Yeah, this is going to be like a 30-some episode game, which is why I've been considering playing another game like one day of the week, but the sooner we get this, the more we work on this, the sooner it gets done, the sooner I can move on. So the first glass is lit by the spotlight. The second glass is lit by the spotlight. Karen takes the poison glass. The two drink at the same time. Karen begins writhing in pain. Why did Karen take the poison glass? Because of the script. Karen and dies. For whom did the trio commit the crime? Mystery unraveled! And then we're going to go through all that without me voiceoverings. And it'll be done correctly. Karen vomits pink blood. All right, here we go. I'm going to be quiet. Stage. Actually.
This case begins with Aiko's death 6 months ago.
Akio was thought to have committed suicide by jumping off the roof. Yuru caught and murdered her.
The shoes left on the roof had dirt on them from the flower bed at the crime scene. The bloodstains on the bricks were also unnatural. And it was obvious that an amateur had faked it.
If it wasn't a suicide, it would contradict Cotton's testimony. However, she didn't originally intend to kill Aiko. It was a crime of passion.
So they got into an argument. Cotton saw red, then zoom? Women are so scary.
Women are scary.
Yoshiko, Waruna, and Kurame probably realized the truth behind what happened. The three teamed up to avenge Aiko. They used the dress rehearsal to commit this crime.
Regardless of the reason, getting together to plan a murder is pretty crazy.
Yoshiko and the audience was to bring the poisoned glass into the theater hall.
Once unsealed, the poison is harmless after 30 minutes. So she went to the lab 15 minutes after the play began.
The poison container is too big to transport unnoticed. So she applied it to the glass in her bag with a paintbrush.
Thus, the poison glass was created! She brought it back to the theater hall, then went on standby at the right end of the front row.
Waruna, who was acting on stage, was to switch out the poisoned glass.
During the 5-second blackout 30 minutes into the play, Yoshiko placed the poisoned glass in the wings. Waruna, on stage, retrieved it and hid it under her costume.
Then, in the scene where she approaches the shelf, she exchanged the glass there with the poisoned one.
Switching in the murder weapon on stage while everyone is watching? What a pervy exhibitionist!
Pervy exhibitionist.
What's perverted about that? And Kurane, on the lights, would guide Cotton to take the poisoned glass.
Then came the duel of poison cups! The two glasses on the shelf had juice poured into them. Cotton and Waruna shuffled them in a way the audience couldn't see.
But Kurane, who was on the catwalk directly above the stage, saw exactly which glass held the poison. She confirmed the location of the poisoned glass and shone the spotlight on it first.
Cotton drank from that glass 45 minutes after the start of the play. Winner, winner! Poisoning complete! That was so long! Good job!
Kurane told Cotton of a change in stage direction, but the victim was to take the glass the spotlight hits first. Cotton followed this instruction to take the poisoned one. The whole sequence of events for this crime would have been impossible for a single person. Their cooperation was also a means to conceal their involvement. But I can't shake the feeling that there was some other reason behind it.
Really?
Crime committed by ruthless criminals. Those loathsome culprits are... Yoshiko! Waruna!
I'm waiting for...
They may have pretended to always be at odds with one another, but deep down, they were bonded through their shared admiration for Aiko.
Pouty got a death. His pouty.
Was there really no other way? Was there no way to prove Cotton did this without killing her?
That's not possible.
Not in Kanai Ward. The peacekeepers bend the truth whichever way they want to. The three girls couldn't get justice from them. Which led to this crime.
But that... it doesn't make it right! How long did you put on an act for this?
Aiko was our sunlight. Wherever she went, we were meant to be there with her. She was everything to us.
We were together ever since we were young. Her dream was our dream. We were nothing special. But she called us her rivals. Those words encouraged us to carry on.
But now she's gone. Everything's hopeless now.
The three of us investigated Aiko's death. I used my parents' connections to view top secret case files.
But no matter what we did, the peacekeepers refused to reopen the case. Because Karin's father is a big shot at Amaterasu Corporation.
That's why we had to do it ourselves.
We wanted revenge.
Revenge became everything for us.
And to get it, we pretended to fight amongst ourselves. We are actors, after all.
But we don't have to anymore, right? We don't have to keep this up.
We put on quite a show. Didn't we, Aiko?
This leaves a bad taste in my mouth. Then again, most cases do. But that's the end. We can finally return to the real world. I hope the girls open up like that in the real world, too.
No, I don't think they can.
Huh? Why is that?
Oh, also, where's Shinigami?
Right here.
Well, what do you think? Did you fall in love with me? I know you did. You must have, yeah?
I already told you. I will never fall for you. You are seriously getting on my nerves. You're annoying and exhausting.
Desuhiko?
I would like to discuss things, but I don't want to interrupt dialogues.
Did you think I was serious? I was just testing the bond between you two.
Alright, it's time to go on and read some chat, because the chat's like... Alright, so... game is so long, Karen vomits pink blood and dies. Seriously though, why is the blood neon pink? I think it's a censorship thing. Blood should be red, so clearly something's wrong. It wasn't blood, it was highlighter ink, yeah. Yeah, I think it's a censorship thing, agreed, plot twist. Some Asian countries don't like blood in their video games. Yeah, like I mentioned in the previous video, some country changed all the color of blood to white, so it looks worse in a perverted mindset. Glow stick juice! It was assumed, I just assumed it was some kind of weird stylistic thing. The game already had was weird enough. Yeah, agreed. Japanese censorship makes no sense. I've seen insanely violent Takashi Miike movies. How dare they show a bit of blood splatter in video games, or God forbid, nudity! Well, I googled it, and there is a reason for blood. No spoilers, though. And was that important? I was curious. Just gotta run some errands. I'll see you later. Okay, Bartels. See you later. Have fun. Let's finish this.
Mind. It's more of a curse, at least to me.
Right. I was just testing. I wasn't serious.
I don't know, I wasn't serious.
I didn't
rejected. You did.
I did it.
You're rejected.
All right. Just calm down.
Anyway, let's do it. Time to exterminate the souls of the true culprits and destroy the mystery labyrinth.
Wait, Shinigami. Do we really have to do this? I mean, they...
They're murderers. The reason why doesn't matter. I make my living reaping the souls of criminals. Because I'm Shinigami. Surging bloodlust. Overflowing despair. The brilliant soul of Shinigami shall expunge this cursed case! Death to all deplorables! Ruin to the vile mystery labyrinth!
Shane Bartle's bookshelf had to leave just before the most anime death thing happened. Because this is probably one of the most anime things I've seen in a long time. There's a lot of anime things I've seen, but that was it. That was it. Alright, that's that. Holy criminy. I mean, that is definitely one of those heart-wrenching things. You know, they're trying to get, trying to avenge the death of their friend, so they have to commit this crime to do it. It's one of those moral dilemmas, ethical dilemmas that you have to deal with. So... Oh, faint. Faint. Faint.
What? What's going on?
Permafaints.
The evil murderers have been expunged once again. Oh, right. There's still one more job I gotta do.
Excuse me, everyone. The culprits behind this incident were Waruna, Karne, and myself. All three of us conspired to poison Karin. The way we got her to ingest the poison was...
I don't know what you people have done, but next time it won't go your way. Remember that.
Did you see that?
She was staring at me the whole time. She's gotta be in love with me. Oh, fine. I guess she can keep the peace of my love as well. What's got you so down? All three of them just died out of nowhere. Nobody's to blame for that. There's no reason for either of us to feel guilty.
Yeah.
Seems like all the memories from the mystery labyrinth are completely gone. Master, we're in the clear. All three of their deaths won't be your fault now.
Well,
that's not what I'm worried about. Rumi?
Thank you for saving me. I knew you'd come to the rescue.
Anyway, are you all right? The peacekeepers didn't harm you, did they?
No, I'm fine.
Hey, Yuma? I don't want to get in the way of this tearful reunion. But maybe we should get out of here. It'll be trouble if the peacekeepers come back.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, right. Let's leave then.
That was an interesting transition. It went from like a 3D shrinking transition to a sketch of the Shinigami ghost form. It was interesting, that's all. I just thought it was interesting. So, who is going to assist us in the next case? I bet you it's going to be Viz. You know, the one that I always talk as I'm yawning. Oh yeah, I'm just going to be chilling out here in the fireplace, you know?
I'm going to head to the agency and put in a good word for you. I don't really get how it all ended, but I have a hunch. Yuma, you did all the work, right?
Huh?
Oh, guess he's got that intuition.
Looks like I won't be calling you rookie from here on out. Let's keep working together, my man. Mind your manners as you walk your girl home.
Huh? What is it?
This tension. Don't tell me. Is this where they make babies? Did something happen? You seem down.
No, you know what? Yeah, we're just going to move on. We're just going to move on.
Oh.
What? We're moving on. Were they what? Even Chad's confused.
Three lives were lost.
Right. I didn't expect Yoshiko and the others to. Could it be that their deaths are related to your forte?
What?
Wow. We've got another sharp one. Master, I hope you know this, but if you say anything about our contract... Oh, sorry for saying something so strange. I know I'm off, right? Even if that were the case, you'd never tell me.
Hey, Kurumi. There's somewhere I want to go.
Come
with me?
Sure. I guess.
That's it. He goes bangs? The bangs? Particular about how his bangs looks. His bangs. Like, his bangs. It takes him seconds to get a costume perfect, precise, pristine, exact. But he spends an hour a day on his bangs?
What a nice view! It's like a secret hideout. I didn't know that Kamisaki had a place like this.
Please, help me save this city.
Save this city, huh? I managed to save Kurumi by solving the case. But I killed those three girls. I'm responsible for their demise. If I had let the peacekeepers deal with it, at least their deaths could have been prevented.
Yeah, but she would have died. An innocent.
Did I even solve? It's not a true solution if we can't save everyone.
What I gained in exchange for my memories isn't some convenient mystery-solving tool. It's literally the power of a death god.
Yeah, you are correct.
What are you musing about? You can't reclaim the past, and you're not gonna get your memories back either. In the end, you just have to accept it.
Accept it?
Instead of believing in some vague justice, just the truth.
Yeah.
Say there's only one truth, and there's only one type of person who can find their way to that truth. Detectives.
Even if I have to sacrifice others to find it, I should let so many people die for the truth?
Master, you keep going to extremes. It's part of why you're a greenhorn. Seems like you still have much to learn under my guidance.
What is the truth? Why did I become a detective to seek it?
I'm okay with that question, but how he's doubting everything, it just doesn't make much sense.
Oh, yes?
I know I already said this, but thank you so much. You are exactly the kind of person I thought you were.
What do you mean by that?
You're my hero.
I'm no hero. I was just trying to expose the truth.
But thanks to you, I was saved. If you weren't around, I wouldn't be here today.
Exactly.
That's why a detective who exposes the truth is a hero in my book. If there were more detectives like you in this city, maybe Aiko's death would have been solved earlier.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure things would have been different.
Oh.
Kanai Ward hasn't seen a hero like you in forever. That's why it's always been so dark here.
Oh, because the ellipsis is just a whore.
Continue to be our hero.
A hero.
Oh.
Maybe before I lost my memories, I was trying to become someone's hero. This time, there was a steep price to be paid for exposing the truth. But even so, the truth must always be revealed. I want to believe I can save someone. I want to continue being the hero she says I am. Still, I don't want to use Shinigami's powers again.
Don't act like you don't like it, Master. Well, I'm just glad you seem more motivated now.
That's motivated.
Didn't we? I said I'd tell you about Kanai Ward's
ultimate secret.
Huh? Oh, right.
Hey, you seem like you weren't expecting much. But that's where you're wrong. Just between you and me, I am Kanai Ward's only informant.
Oh, of course.
Informant?
Of course.
I started 3 years ago after taking over from my grandfather. And now that the peacekeepers control the city, there isn't much of a demand for information anymore.
No wonder you know so much about rumors. Besides...
I'll stop.
Since I was chased by those peacekeepers.
I'll stop doing that.
That also explains why the peacekeepers were after you. Rumi is an informant. Maybe she does have some crucial information about Kanai Ward's ultimate
secret. The ultimate secret of ultimate secretness is ultimately a secret of secretness of ultimatity. What was that? I thought I saw letters on the left-hand side of the screen. I might have been mistaken. I might have been mistaken. Let's just wait a minute. Let's just wait a second. You good? I don't know. I thought I saw like... You know what? We good. Let's move on. Let's move on.
So, Kurumi, what do you know about Kanai Ward's
ultimate secrets?
Well, it's likely connected to the top secret research that Amaterasu Corporation is conducting. I think it has something to do with why the unified government approved of Kanai Ward's isolation.
Top secret research? Approved the isolation?
Kanai Ward has always been a city centered around Amaterasu. But there was a lot more freedom in the past. People were allowed to come and go as they pleased. It became an autonomous zone, free from the Yuji's
influence
only a few years ago. The reason behind it has to do with the top secret research that Amaterasu is conducting.
But what is the research?
I don't know all the details, but it's supposed to be able to change the entire structure of the world.
Well, it's raining 24/7.
Worldwide wanted. This research is what turned Amaterasu into a major global corporation.
And that research is being done in Kanai Ward?
I think so. It would explain why Kanai Ward's been isolated. It's so their research doesn't leak out.
Research that can change the world? If that's true, it's some serious stuff. No wonder number one of the WDO would risk his life here.
Do you know any more details about that research?
I do know a little bit. Grandpa risked his life to obtain one piece of confidential information about Amaterasu Corp. And I believe that somehow, it has to be related.
Somehow?
What do you mean?
Research to create a homunculus. An immortal monster.
Homunculus? Immortal monster? Now, wait just a minute.
Play with me, Alphonse. I was debating on whether or not I should go that route, but I did, and I still regret it. Moving on.
Are you serious?
Play with me, Edward. Play with me, Edward.
But it's a fact that
rude. I know. I'm sorry.
Has previously researched homunculi.
Homunculi being researched in this city. Is that Kanai Ward's
ultimate secret?
Immortal monsters? Homunculi? It's turned into a fantasy story out of nowhere. Oh, I'm sure not one to talk.
That's all I know. Well, is my information useful to you? Although, most of it was left behind by my grandpa.
Left behind?
One day, my grandpa just vanished. He's been missing ever since. That's why I decided to take over where Grandpa left off as an informant. So, do you think what I've shared might help?
I will give this game all my money if Ed and Al just come running through and shove Yuma out of the way.
Yeah, this is huge, considering how I had nothing until now.
I actually missed this informant.
Oh, about that master detective thing.
Look, that's where my grandpa used to live. Oh, that takes me back. I wish I could see him again.
Oh well.
And that's how you'll keep taking advantage of a high school girl.
By the way, Kurumi. Why do you think your grandfather disappeared? Could it be the peacekeepers?
No, I don't think the peacekeepers have anything to do with it. Grandpa vanished before Kanai Ward became isolated. He was just suddenly gone. But I do believe I'll see him again someday.
In the afterlife.
Forget about some geezer you don't even know. What about this homunculus stuff?
Homunculus Research. If Amaterasu Corporation is still researching some immortal monster in Kanai Ward, it makes sense why there'd be such tight security. They fear the secret leaking to the outside world. Maybe it even has something to do with the great global mystery that number one.
Great global mystery.
Which? What could the great global mystery
be? Great global mystery.
There's too much stuff we don't know, but you're one step ahead of the other detectives now, yeah? I guess that flat chested Uggo is kinda useful. Maybe I should stop calling her Uggo now. I'll just call her Flat.
She's not flat!
We're gonna hold on to that, huh? I guess this is technically an improvement.
You're gonna keep this info to yourself, right? It'll help you get ahead of the other master detectives.
No, I'll report this to everyone. This isn't something I can deal with alone.
Agreed.
Ugh, how lame. Couldn't you strike a pose and shout something like, I'm coming
for you, Amaterasu.
That's not my roar. All I can do is investigate Kanai Ward's ultimate
secrets.
The rest should be left to the real master detectives to handle.
This is my fault as your mentor.
Look,
you so much.
I did not say anything about return the slab. Okay, I was talking about Full Metal Alchemist homunculi incident. Okay, that's it. I was making babies cry. I had nothing to do with return the slab.
You've become the kind of detective who only relies on others without trying to solve problems yourself.
It's a team effort.
What's wrong with relying on others?
For today.
The pleasure is all mine.
Ooh, pleasure.
I'm kinda hungry. Maybe I should go buy a meat bun on the way home.
By the way.
You like those meat buns too, huh?
Yeah, she likes sausage in her mouth.
I love them. I eat at least one every 2 days. They're kind of the comfort food of Kanai Ward. It's like I'm instinctively drawn to them.
What if these meat buns are actually created by the Amaterasu Corporation to gradually infect people with chemicals to turn them into an army of homunculi? You know, this game is pretty, I'd say, dark enough, for lack of a better term. They're not afraid to wipe out an entire, well, so basically wipe out people who are, I wouldn't necessarily say innocent, but innocent-hearted. If that makes sense. So I wouldn't put it past him.
Oh, would you like to join me, Yuma?
No, thanks. I'll pass.
I see. Will we meet again?
Huh? Yeah, of course.
That's great! If you ever need any information, you can count on me. See you later.
I hope she's okay on her own.
She's never been on her own before.
Self to say, I'll walk you home.
Just say it. What are you, 12?
10, right?
You sure you don't want to go back to the agency? Weren't you running an errand a while ago?
Oh, you're right. Oh no, I'd better hurry back.
You see what I mean? It's just like the shape of the Shinigami ghost form just shrinking down into a picture of exactly what that shape was. It's a very interesting transition to me. Not a bad interesting either. A dark parchment in the background, slightly tilted to give it an off balance, but the fold is centered, but the parchment isn't. I don't know, I think the fold is throwing me off in terms of this.
Return the slab.
Homunculus research. I still can't believe it's true. Does it ring a bell, Chief?
Unfortunately, I've never even heard of it. You sure it's not just some rumor?
Well,
the way Kurumi explains
kind of.
It makes me to think it's true.
Currently, it is a rumor.
There's too little information. We lack anything definite at the moment. Still, it's better than having nothing at all. Well done, Yuma. Thank you.
You're like a dog wagging its tail whenever you get
wag, 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 wag.
You were late getting back, but I never imagined you'd get yourself into another mess. Ugh, what the hell is going on?
Okay, okay, so that was intentional. For some reason, I thought that was a typo I needed to address because it was so... It threw my ass for a loop. Like, look at this.
What the hell is going on?
What the hell is going on?
I'm so angry, I'm talking with the last!
What?
Setting aside how I nearly died of hunger and that Yuma needs to be put on a leash, you picked another fight with the peacekeepers! That's the biggest problem here!
We weren't picking a fight. Besides, we got to expose the truth in the end.
That look on Martina's face was awesome! Right, Yuma?
That's not what I'm talking about! How can you be so relaxed?
There, Lisp Man. Please remain calm.
So, is it true the culprits in that case suddenly died? That makes it similar to what happened in the mailman case.
He has a lisp. Don't be cruel. Look, I didn't bring it up, but the game did. The game's being cruel. I feel like the VA started talking with a lisp. And just wanted to keep in the script. I don't know. But still.
Moreover, it is also similar in that those involved in each case, like Desuhiko and myself, had their memories wiped. There are too many common traits to call it a coincidence.
The memories related to the case disappear. Perhaps it is due to someone's forte.
No way. What kind of useless forte would that be? Besides, no one here has an ability like that.
Could another master detective have found their way here?
Yes, but we don't know it yet.
Or anywhere else in the world, but... We're in Kanai Ward. This isn't the kind of place some ambitious master detective could barge into by himself. If someone got officially dispatched here, I would know.
Anyway, why are you all looking so glum? The case is closed and we got new information. It's a fantastic step forward.
Thank you, Blackstar.
It's springtime and all is right in the world.
You are wildly incorrect about both of those.
Nothing but trouble. Just what the hell is going on here?
It feels like the
hand of death itself.
What's wrong, Vivia?
You know what they say. The greater the detective, more often they encounter death. Isn't that right, Yuma?
Oh yeah, that's totally what I mean. Every time he talks, I want to yawn.
In a way, you're like a death.
Death detective.
Don't take it the wrong way. I mean that as a compliment. But even if it offends you, I refuse to apologize. Apologizing is too much of a hassle.
The death detective. You have a cool nickname, Yuma.
No way! I don't want a nickname like that!
Really? But it sounds so awesome!
It seems death has taken a liking to you, Uma. That's one of your talents, in a way.
Sheesh. I'll never understand this guy.
I'll figure out how to discipline Uma later. For now, we need to come up with a plan to handle the peacekeepers. You said this case involved Vice Director Martina, right?
Martina!
She's Director Yumi's right-hand woman.
Right hand.
I heard she's both his close advisor and his mistress. I'm sure they're gonna make a move somehow. I don't even want to think about it.
What'll they do?
See? This is what I'm talking about! Everyone, brace yourselves!
Are you serious?
You are in a submarine. I really want to work with Fubuki. I really do.
The agency is sinking.
What are you sinking about? I love that commercial.
Somebody help.
Hey, Master! Snap out of it! Come on!
What's going on now? What is going on? So the submarine sprung a leak. Subs don't spring leaks at all. So this is very uncommon, you know, for something underwater going under, undergoing a lot of pressure to suddenly spring a leak like that. It doesn't happen.
Boom! Oh, it sank, all right. This is the bolt of judgment, the fire of purification, a supernova explosion! Hey! Who prepared that torpedo?
Unfortunately, it was I, Martina Electro.
Unnecessary.
I figured it was you.
Ocean Gate 2? Damn! It's rough.
That wasn't enough firepower! I told you to blow up the whole river and vaporize them, didn't I?
Who was the billionaire? Fubuki. Fubuki was the billionaire, actually. Because remember, she's supposed to be very, very wealthy, but has, like, a memory of a gnat or something like that. Or the memory, like, demeanor of a gnat, more or less.
Now it just looks like I'm causing chaos. Half-assed executions of the law are nothing but senseless violence.
I find that character boring and annoying. Hell smile. I don't like that character design.
I told you to demonstrate perfect order. Listen to me. A clean and pure execution of the law is overwhelming, absolute, and completely blows everything away without a trace.
I'm terribly sorry, Director Yomi.
No matter. You are my beloved right hand.
What kind of relationship is this? I can't recall the exact phrasing, but chat, help me out here. Gaslit relationship? Abusive? Obviously physical, verbal, emotional, psychological. But like, what kind of relationship is this?
You only need to remain by my side.
Yes. Thank you. I will forever be by your side to serve you.
Thing is,
abusive is a good
even
word.
Though you're
okay.
My beloved right hand, you still need to be punished.
He is holding a crop in his left hand.
You couldn't even solve a case caused by a couple of brats. Not to mention the detectives escaped under your watch. But it's all right. Don't worry. You are my beloved right hand. I won't hurt you. I need you to stay pretty for me forever.
So, Martine's character design reminded me of one of those load screen infos about the nun's red stockings. And how Martine has red stockings. and Martine's parents or something like that. Manipulative, toxic, yeah. Is someone high up in the Amaterasu Corporation. So I'm wondering if they're related. They made a point to put it in a load screen. So it has to be important at some point. Just like I think at least one of the detectives from the beginning survived. And I think it's Pucci. I think Pucci survived. At least. I saw some love bombings. Keeping her in the situation with compliments and gentleness. That's a form of gaslighting. Yeah. Terrible. Just gross. I don't like the character design. I don't like the character.
So, what is my punishment?
Oh, what is my punishment, Daddy?
See this? It's a recent invention by Amaterasu Corporation called a high-performance presser. It can compress up to 50 kilograms of material and instantly turn it into a cube. Even humans can be turned into pretty little cubes.
This is sounding more and more like Ocean Gate.
Keep you on my person at all times, so you'll always be by my side. You are my beloved right hand.
Please wait! What? You must be joking!
This is a stupid character design. It gets worse.
You. Take my beloved right hand over there. Oh, Martina, there's something I wanted to ask you before you go. What's love? Take her away.
Director Yomi! Director Yomi!
They're making zero effort on this character design, huh?
Go find the corpses of those detectives that got blown up.
All right.
Good day, sir. Number one, the leader of the World Detective Organization.
That's him? I have no idea. Why would someone that high up be here underground?
There's a book vault here. It's a secret book vault that only number one can enter with his biometrics. It supposedly contains data from generations of great detectives, sealed books, and so on.
What
is this? Going in there, newbie.
I know. Wasn't number one carrying an old book just now? I wonder what that book was.
The book was a number two.
Well, how about you go investigate? You may be a trainee, but you're still a detective.
Investigate?
I found that rather interesting. Not the dialogue or anything, just the design itself and how the humanoids were depicted in just straight like straight scratches to, I don't know. That wasn't very well phrased. But how like character designs were like just lines, like threads. You got the shape of a character, but you can see through them and stuff like that. I don't know. I just found it interesting.
Wait, where am I?
Weren't you awake?
Weren't you by my side the whole time? Don't you know what happened to us? Like that time back at the Amaterasu Express.
I was only able to stay awake back then because we just made the pact
We weren't fully synchronized yet.
Okay.
But that didn't work this time.
I like how a lot of the questions that I have, like the plot hole questions, are almost immediately explained after. I appreciate that. I appreciate that.
When you lose consciousness, my vision also goes dark.
Ooh, spooky.
Actually, do you remember drifting in the river after the explosion? You almost died. Hell, even as a death god, I thought I was gonna die.
Yeah.
Okay, so far. Now, let's go find out where we are. I want to go exploring so bad, my eyes are watering.
That's a bit dramatic.
Okay.
Where are we?
Let's check things out for now.
All right, following the right-hand wall. Still following the right-hand wall. Alright, I'll stop.
Oh.
It won't open. It's locked somehow. Alright, we're kicking it down. I don't have that kind of strength.
Is this
a painting? I can't tell what it's depicting at all. Truly an inspired piece. Shinigami, do you know how to interpret arts? Definitely not. I'm just saying whatever pops into my head. Yeah. We'll get to that one here shortly. I think this is what's called abstract. Looking at it makes you feel anxious. If it were up to you, Master, won't you title it cul-de-sac? Trash. That's uncalled for. A large TV built into the wall. Power's off, so I can see myself, my own reflection of the screen. Useful and watching spicy videos. That's not what I'm thinking about. Does that mean you're going to think about it later? Let's see. What else? I think that's it. So that means this is the only interactive item to do something. That one's bacon and eggs. That's a sperm and drink and egg. Weird interpretations of anime.
Who's there?
Alright. What the hell is that? What?
Hi there. Nice to meet you. I sure look suspicious, huh?
Oh wait, it's a twink. Save current progress? Yeah, let's do it. Oh wait, it's a twink. You kill me, chat, you kill me. But what was with that mask? We'll have to find out next time. That just about does it for this episode. If you enjoyed the content, like, subscribe, notifications, comment, or get a twink mask and kidnap people wandering around rivers. I don't know. Whatever Twitch, YouTube, Facebook, Discord, wherever you're watching from nowadays, want to do. Who knows? It changes all the time. Check out my website, jpedger.com. Got my books, my blog, my merch, and my stream schedule, as well as, probably has more stuff. But a reminder, live stream, Let's Play Archives, the separate channels, and those links will be in the description. I know. Check it out. Fucking magic. Out of all that, I gotta bleep out the very end. Thank you very much, everyone. I really do appreciate you coming in, making fun of me, and just joining me for this ridiculous ride. And like always, more ridiculous to come.